Let's return from our two previous episodes about the Amazons, the legendary female warriors, and come back to what we were talking about under the warrior archetype at the beginning, the Battle of Thermopylae and the 300 Spartans stand against the Persians. Let me kind of reset the stage for you. I want to tell you exactly what happened in the battle. So to set the stage, the Persian king Xerxes, with an army of 2 million men, according to Herodotus, and a fleet of 1,000 ships, is coming to invade Greece. Now, the only feasible route, because the country is something like this, what you see behind me, there's no way an army can march through that kind of country. The only way through is through this narrow pass of Thermopylae, with the mountains on one side and the sea on the other side. So the Greeks decide to send a detachment of 300 Spartans supported by 4,000 allies to hold this narrow pass for as long as they possibly can, while the rest of the cities can rally and put together a true resistance. So the Spartans arrive at the pass with their allies, having marched up from southern Greece, and they occupy the pass before the Persians have arrived. They rebuild this wall that had been there for centuries, the Phocian wall, and they set up their defense. And then the next day, the Persians do arrive. They establish a camp back down a trail about a mile, and it takes them a little while, a couple of days, to get their whole army in position down there. This is the time when the Persian king Xerxes sets up a throne on a hill to watch the coming battle, and an officer of his arrives and demands that the Spartans lay down their arms, to which King Leonidas responds with the famous two words, "Molon labe," come and take them. The next day, the battle starts, and just wave after wave of Persians and their allies come after the Spartans in this narrow space. The day goes on. It's an incredibly long day, and the Spartans kill, and their allies kill, 40 of the Persians for every one man they lose. But by the end of the day, they can see that although they can hold off for a while, this is not going to last against 2 million men. The day ends. Overnight, the big fear that the Spartans and Leonidas have is that they will be flanked and enveloped, that somehow the Persians will find a way behind them to get behind the mountain and attack them from the rear. And it turns out that this is exactly what happens. There's a traitor of the Greeks, not a Spartan, but another traitor whose name today, that's a raven flying overhead, whose name today in Greek means nightmare. He gave away this one pass, this secret path that could go around them. Day two happens. Same thing, wave after wave of Persians and their allies come after the Spartans. Again, they hold them off. But by now, the elite force of Xerxes, called the 10,000 Immortals, are on this mountain track coming around behind the Spartans. That night, the second night, in a kind of a desperation move, because the Spartans know there's really no hope if they get enveloped, they send a raid into the Persian camp, a small raid, trying to reach Xerxes to find his tent and kill him. Nobody knows exactly what happens, but it didn't work. Day three, on the morning, the Persian Immortals have come around behind the Spartans. They haven't got there yet. They've defeated a contingent that was meant to defend this mountain trail, and they're on their way. They've got, like Leonidas and the Spartans and their allies, have maybe 2 hours to go before they're completely enveloped. So at this point, Leonidas releases the allies to go home to live to fight another day. And who stays behind are the original 300 Spartans, led by their king Leonidas, plus the warriors of an allied city called Thespiae. They decide they're going to stay too, to stay and die, which to me is kind of the most touching part of the whole thing, is what they call the servants of the battle train. They decided to stay too, the armor bearers, the squires, and they took whatever armor they had of the wounded and the dead, and everybody prepared to face them. Now it's the final morning, and Leonidas gives his one final speech to his men, the gist of which is, they all knew going in they were not going to survive. The whole point of this defense of the pass was to buy time for the allies behind them, but also to inspire them with the courage of these guys who were willing to stand and die. So on the final morning, the Persian Immortals come around behind them. The rest of the army comes out. The Spartans retreat to a place called the Knoll. They make certain rushes and drive the Persians back a little bit, but the Persians just keep firing javelins and arrows and javelins and arrows until they've just cut them down and there's nobody left. Xerxes arrives on the scene of all the dead Spartans. He finds Leonidas' corpse, orders it beheaded, and the head put on a pike. And the whole Persian army walks through past Thermopylae and into southern Greece. By the way, Xerxes desperately regretted that later and felt it was a dishonorable act. Anyway, the Persians go in, they burn Athens to the ground. The Athenians have retreated, left their city entirely, and taken to their ships. Athens has a great navy. And sure enough, the Battle of Salamis, the Bay of Salamis, south of Athens, in that battle that comes right after this, the Athenians win. They destroy the Persian fleet, or at least reduce it enough that they have to withdraw back to Persia. And when that happens, the whole army has to back off too. So the army, the Persian army, spends that winter kind of in winter quarters. And in the spring, there's a battle at a place called Plataea. And at this time, the entire Spartan army is there with all their allies, 100,000 strong, and allies from all the other Greek cities. And sure enough, they kick the Persians' butt and drive them back across the Aegean. And that was the saving of Western civilization, the saving of everything we hold dear, democracy and all of that stuff. So the point of this story is that the defense at Thermopylae, although it was a tactical defeat, everybody lost, everybody died, by that sacrifice and by the bravery there, the Spartans and their allies inspired the rest of the Greeks and saved us and gave us everything that we have, the freedom and the democracy that we still have today.